Hey, good afternoon. Happy Thursday. Welcome back to the Mainsail Financial Group weekly update. Thank you guys for your patience during the holiday weekend there last week. Hope everybody had a good time, was able to enjoy a little different look at Thanksgiving, but you know, hopefully still enjoy some time with friends and family. It's interesting. The week before Thanksgiving, actually, I went on just kind of a quick little trip down to Palm Springs. So I wasn't able to enjoy Thanksgiving with family because I was kind of self-quarantining, but I can't complain. It was super nice. It was sunny, but it was really interesting. That's the first time personally I've taken a trip during the COVID world that we're in. You know, it's really interesting to just kind of absorb what's going on in the whole travel experience. My way down there, I didn't even think anything of it. The airports were pretty empty. You know, seats around me were completely open. I had a late flight, so that might have something to do with it. But on the way back, it was a little different story. There was definitely a lot more people. You know, the airports were a little more packed. So it was just really interesting to kind of take this all in this kind of second wave of the, you know, of these COVID infections, and just kind of see, you know, what's going on out there, because it's so easy to get trapped in kind of our, you know, our home bubble. And, you know, the world is turning. I think it's a, you know, it's a good sign. Obviously, you know, hopefully people are being safe and everybody's staying healthy, but it is a good sign for the economy and something to kind of consider. Down in California might have been a little different story. There was definitely a lot that was closed down, but the golf courses were open, so I can't complain. Anyway, let's jump right into things. There is so much to cover, especially with the week that we took off there last week. So let's start right there. There was a lot of data that came out during the short Thanksgiving week, and so I want to jump in to some of this. You know, and the first thing that we address every week is initial jobless claims. So initial jobless claims came out last week, not today, last week, at about 778,000. A little higher than expected, but you know, still kind of semi in line with what was expected as far as those numbers go. We also had GDP revisions come out. As you might remember, the number was, I think, 33.1% GDP growth. Now, don't get used to this. Again, as we talked about before, this is a quick recovery from that huge, huge negative GDP number we had the previous quarter. But you know, it's a huge number nonetheless. And it did come down just slightly. I think it was 33.5% or so originally, but not a big change necessarily. We had consumer spending, which was up just slightly. We also had core inflation, which again, we've talked about the measure of inflation, but remember not to take this with too much certainty. There's a lot in the measure of inflation that really we're not spending money on. So of course that's not growing, but it came out at zero. I think we all feel it a little differently when we go buy groceries, or, you know, for those who may be doing home improvements, go buy lumber, those kind of things. It's there. It's just in a different form that's not feeding into the numbers. All right. Then we move forward into this week. This week we had a good amount of things come out as well. We had Chairman Powell and Mnuchin testifying on the CARES Act funds, which has been kind of interesting. You know, we haven't spent all of the monies that were put aside for that. And so it's been interesting to see what's going to come of that, where those monies will go. And just Tuesday this week, we had motor vehicle sales. For those who watch this pretty regularly, you'll know that that's something that we watch pretty closely. Sales, but also motor vehicle sales can be kind of a pretty big indicator of what's going on in the economy. So it's like 15.6 million, I think, something like that. Just good to see that. Yesterday, we had the ADP employment report come out. I'm starting to take this with a little grain of salt. This number, it came out at 307,000, but tomorrow we have the non-farms payroll number, which has been what I've really been lately paying a little more attention to. So watch that number tomorrow. We'll talk about it next week, Thursday at 3 p.m. too. But that non-farms payroll number is really important. And then today we had initial jobless claims come out, of course, as well. Again, this is a weekly number, but that came out at a little over 710,000, I believe was the number. So I think we're heading in the right direction. Hopefully that continues on the jobless claims. As we move into more restrictions, though, in a lot of states, obviously that's a big concern that we're watching moving forward. And then again, looking forward, tomorrow is a big day. We've got non-farm payrolls and unemployment. You know, if we look backwards, especially during this period, we talked about this range that we were kind of in the markets. And actually, I believe it was two Thursdays ago, the last time we were on, we talked about just kind of slightly breaking out of that finally. And that sometimes when we break out of that range, that can kind of act as a new bottom. And that's actually been what's happening to some degree. I mean, November was a great month in the markets. Saw a lot of shift to some of the cyclical names and things like that, which was good to see as well. I think that's healthy. So interesting to see what happens moving forward. Keep in mind that those ceilings and those floors are not permanent. Those are short-term measures. So don't take that too much to heart. And then next week, we're going to have initial jobless claims, of course, on Thursday. We have CPI next week, the federal budget, which is something that has been on a lot of people's minds lately. That'll be really interesting to watch. And then consumer sentiment as well. So I want to kind of end with sharing some things. So on that trip that I was on, and over the past quarter or so, I've been working really hard. The whole flights there and back, I was working on writing, actually. So very excited to share this. Some of you may already be aware of this, but I've actually been working really hard on writing a book lately. So I'm happy to say that sometime Q1 2021, this will be done, published, like ready to go, printed, ready to go. So very excited about this. It is kind of the full gamut of retirement planning. It is a little bit more for people who might be closer to or in retirement, but there's something for everybody in there. And you know, we're really excited to just kind of use this and get this out there as much as possible. So we're actually going to be giving away free copies. And in fact, the first 100 people who sign up for their free copy, who claim that they would like a copy of the book, are actually going to go into a drawing for a free financial plan. And I don't say that lightly. Those who know us know what that means. This is going to be the full process, you know, every step of the planning process, the actual deliverable plan itself. But more importantly, you know, myself and our team as a resource to you to really dig into those different planning strategies. The book's going to give you plenty of information on that stuff as well, but just to round it out and just make it even more solid, we thought this would be kind of a great compliment to kind of reward those who are, you know, who are excited about the book as we are and would like to, you know, claim their free copy. So if that's you, if you want to, you know, make that claim and kind of get in the drawing, you can either email us, email me directly, send me a message directly, whatever works, or you can text us as well, 425-502-7693. Again, 425-502-7693. You can probably tell I'm pretty dang excited about this. I put a lot of work into it and really excited to kind of break this like mind-numbing version of financial planning and share what you can do to really take a little more control of your future. So very excited to get this out. Whether you're the first 100 or not, let us know if you want a copy, but definitely if you want to be involved in that drawing, reach out here soon and we'd be happy to kind of get you into that opportunity for, you know, free planning and free plan process with us. So thanks so much for your time. That's where we'll break today. We will look forward to seeing you same place, same time next Thursday, 3 p.m. If you do have any questions for us as well outside of the book, definitely don't hesitate to reach out. We'd be happy to get some feedback and what we can do to make this even better. For those who aren't already, follow us, you know, subscribe to our YouTube channel if this is helpful. And that way we can make sure to kind of give you these digestible weekly updates moving forward. Thanks so much. We'll see you next Thursday.